In another video, I talked about how we can't really force society to just change. I mean, a situation can happen and we can react to it a certain way, obviously, like what happened after 9/11. But, you know, if we're trying to make social change, we can only make it go so fast. People's open-mindedness can only go so fast. Now, the thing is, which I didn't mention in that video, and I feel it's important for me to mention, is if we're not trying to do anything at all for social change, then this isn't even going to happen. It's just going to stay like this, or it could even go like this. So, I mean, we have to do something. We have to talk about some of these issues, but we just have to realize that people's open-mindedness is only going to go up at a certain rate. You can't get it to go any faster. But if you don't do anything at all, it's going to become stagnant. So I just wanted to state that. So, I mean, I think some people may have taken my video as if, we don't really have to do anything and it'll just change. Well, there will be some change, but it takes a very, very long time. The thing is, we need to bring up subjects reasonably. Okay? One of the things that I do admire about feminists is that they're trying to do something about what they see in front of them. They see some problems, they want to find some way to address them. Unfortunately, they usually like use feminist theory to look at everything. And it's, and there's many ways that we can look at a problem. So I think we need to start looking at these problems different ways. If you don't view what they're talking about as actual problems, well, try to frame the things that they're talking about differently, and maybe we can have a different discussion. But even if you don't find something very important, I mean, like for instance, okay, a lot of people found Gamergate really important. That the people who looked at Gamergate as being, well, it's all about ethics and gaming journalism. And of course, it had another side to it as well. It was all these different things wrapped in one, and people can't say, well, no, it's only about ethics and gaming journalism. I'm like, no, that's not all it's about, but that's a part of it. That's what it supposedly was supposed to be about. And, you know, whatever. A lot of people made a huge deal about it. But what does it really boil down to? Was that really a big deal? Well, for some people it is. Some people feel that video games are very serious business and that corruption in gaming journalism is far more important than corruption in mainstream news media, is definitely more important than corruption in alternative media. You know, it's games, it's really important. And for some people, that was the case. And people complaining about other types of media that are corrupt, you know, well, you know, I just want stuff that affects me. Okay, fine. You know, if it's really important to you, then great. For some people, it isn't. And so a lot of these things that these feminists talk about, you may have feel that on the level of importance, it's just way, way down there. Okay, fine. But if they are talking about it, if they are talking about some sort of a problem, even if they're overhyping it, even if it's hyperbole, you know, what can be done? What can be done about that problem? I mean, if you're just tired of hearing about it, then come up with a solution so you won't have to hear about it anymore. And I'd say the same thing to the feminists who didn't want to really do much to try to tackle what Gamergate supposedly was trying to address. You just addressed the bullying part of it, which is understandable, but you weren't really addressing the things that they were saying Gamergate's about. So that was kind of frustrating, you know? I mean, all sides do this sort of thing once in a while, but I mean, if something isn't that important to you, but you can see it's important to other people, you know, and you're tired of hearing about it, then say something that maybe can help them. Give some advice. Maybe try to help them take care of the problem so you don't have to hear about it anymore. That's my take on this. So, you know, I just wanted to say again, you know, people's open-mindedness is only going to increase at that rate that it's only possible to go, that only happens when people are making an attempt. So I just wanted to make that clear. If people took that other video as if I'm saying, you know, let's just not do anything. Well, no, that's definitely not what I'm trying to say. So, and some people kind of take that route. It's one of my frustrations with a number of anti-feminist positions. It's just like, well, let's not do anything. And it'll just fall into place. Well, yeah, maybe after, you know, 40 more years or something, yeah, it'll just fall into place then. But, and then there might be some things that we become more, less open-minded in. So, I mean, there has to be a push for this. Some of this push is kind of goes with our whole creative flow of society. So, I do think that this presidency is going to make us be very creative, and we're going to be very much on our toes. We might even be at our best when it comes to trying to tackle real issues. So, then again, I said real issues. Well, I guess that phrase is debatable. So,